Glancing outside, they watch the next-door apartment move away. Mark warns his neighbour, Jody. But from Jody's perspective, it looks like Lotus and Mark are moving away. Who do you think is correct? This scenario illustrates that all motion is relative. Both of these claims are correct because they are made from different viewpoints. Let's consider another example. It's tempting to believe that your classroom is stationary because you cannot see it moving. Now, let's expand our scope of view. The Earth rotates about its axis. The Earth orbits the Sun, and the solar system travels through our galaxy. Therefore, an outside observer would claim that your classroom is moving. Consequently, we need to be aware of our frame of reference. This is a coordinate system used for making observations and taking measurements, but you can think of it as a particular point of view. In our earlier example, Lotus and Mark had a different viewpoint to Jody. If they account for the relative motion between their frames of reference, they would come to the same conclusion that they are moving apart. In physics, an inertial frame of reference is one that moves with a constant velocity. A car travelling at 40 kilometres per hour along a straight road is an inertial frame of reference. Another example is a car stopped at a traffic light. Meanwhile, a non-inertial frame of reference is one that accelerates. If you drive around a roundabout, then your direction constantly changes. And if you go skydiving, then your speed constantly increases. In this lesson, we will calculate the relative velocities of objects as measured in different inertial frames of reference. We won't consider non-inertial frames of reference because they are complicated. Let's start with a simple example. A car and a motorbike race east along a straight road at 100 kilometres per hour. What is the velocity of the motorbike relative to the car? Pause here to think about your answer. To take measurements relative to the car, we should imagine ourselves sitting inside the car. They both travel at the same speed in the same direction, so the distance between them is constant, and the relative velocity is 0 km per hour.